So for the first time in India, now we have a simple way of registering a drone and making them legal. So if you want to know how, keep watching this video. On the 13th of January 2020, the Indian Civil Aviation Department has made a very important announcement in which you can register your drones online in a very simple and easy way and make them legal in India. For that, there's a very simple and easy process in which you can register your drone in less than 15 minutes. If you own a drone and if you want to register this drone, or you know somebody who owns a drone and is wanting to register this drone, then share this video with him and with all your friends, because this video is going to be very important for everybody who owns a drone in India. But first, let me show you the drone that I'm using currently. It's the DJI Mavic Air, and I've been using this for quite some time, almost like 2 years. I've been using this, flying this all over the country and abroad in a couple of countries, and I'm gonna tell you how I have done that and how I take my drone videos and photographs in India. So if you guys don't know me, my name is Alamgir, and if this is the first time that you are visiting my channel, then please subscribe to my channel. I make a lot of filmmaking, photography and cinematography related videos and tutorials, and do subscribe me and help me grow this channel. So I have traveled all over India with this drone, and there's a very simple way of doing that. So if you want to carry your drone on a flight, you just have to remove your batteries like this and keep it in your hand baggage. Also, remove the propellers. You need to remove all the propellers from your drone. I have carried this drone to Thailand. I have carried this drone to Indonesia, and I have traveled to so many places in India, and I have never faced any problem with this drone. I have always carried this in my camera bag along with all my camera gear, and I never ran into any kind of a problem. People ask me all the time how you have got permission to fly a drone in somewhere, and how I have flown my drone in some particular areas. And let me tell you, I have never taken permission to fly this drone anywhere in India, and because nobody has any definite laws against drones or how to use the drones. So everywhere you go, anywhere you go to the police stations, you ask for the permission, you are never going to get any kind of a permission for this flying this drone, because there is no such rules yet to fly a drone. You just have to be careful, and you have to take your risk, and you fly your drones with your own risk, and you have to be responsible flying a drone. You can't just fly in cities, you can't fly in public places, in crowded places, you can't just fly where there are a lot of people around. You can't do that. You have to be safe. You have to be in some area which has less crowd and there's less people to notice it, and that is the best way of keeping your drone safe and flying without any permission. So I have got up early in the morning only to take drone videos and pictures when there is no people around and not much crowd, so that I can go out and take videos, and it's a safe way of taking videos and pictures in anywhere in India. So one thing keep in mind, then you need to register any drone which is above 250 grams. So if you fly a toy, if you fly any kind of an RC helicopter or any kind of an RC plane or anything which flies with a remote, you need to register if it weighs more than 250 grams. And if it doesn't weigh more than 250 grams, then you don't have to register simply. So for that, first you need to register your drone. You have to enlist this drone with the government, and you have to register yourself and the drone so that you can fly this. That is the first step in registering your drone and making this legal. And the next step is they're going to formulate some rules and regulations and some guidelines for every drone owners and drone flyers, so that there can be a properly regulated way of flying this, I guess. So till now, the only thing you need to do is register your drone which you already own. It's not about the drones you are going to buy, but it is about the drones that you currently own. If you already own a drone, then you need to register this, and the last day to register this drone is 31st December 5 PM. So I am not sure how is it going to be after the deadline of the 31st January. I'm not sure if you're able to register your drones after 31st January. I just know that if you register your drone within this time, your drone will be legal. I don't think you'll be able to buy any of these drones currently. You'll have to buy your drone. If you want to buy a new drone, you have to buy it post 31st Jan, when I think when the sellers or the distributors will be selling the drones, so they will get your drones registered while selling it, and you have to buy a registered drone. So this process is only for people who already owns a drone like me and who want to register and make the drones legal. So registering the drone will not give you the permission and the authority to fly it anywhere in the country, but yes, it will make your drone legal and it will make your drone registered, and you can carry it anywhere in the country. The OIN number and the DIN number that you receive after registering the drone, maybe if you are traveling with the drone after this period, they will be asking you about the DIN number, and if you still don't have the DIN number, your drone might get confiscated. So if you own an unregistered drone after this period, the Indian government can penalize you, they can sue you, and they can seize your drone. So you don't want to do that, and you don't want to get into this trouble. So it's better that you register your drone and make it legal when you still have the time. And there is two-step process. One, you have to register yourself, the owner of the drone, that is myself. So if I am an individual, or if I am a company, if I work for a company, or if I have a small company which flies drones, then we have to register ourselves or the company. So if you are an individual or the company, you have to register yourself. If you are a company, you need a PAN card, and if you are an individual, you do not need details. Once you fill in your details, you register yourself, and you receive a OAN number, which is owner acknowledgement number. So for example, if I own a drone and if I want to register it, I will register my name. I will receive a OIN number which is specific to me, and I can have multiple drones, 4, 5, 10 drones or whatever number of drones, and I will receive a separate DIN number, drone acknowledgement number, for each of these drones. There are a few documents that you require. I suggest you prepare all your documents that you need in a JPEG format, and you keep them ready to upload, because you will get only 25 minutes to upload all the documents, and you cannot save the page, and if you delay, it will just go back and then you have to restart the whole process. So it's better you keep all the documents ready, and you need to take some pictures of your drone. I will tell you how to take the pictures and upload the drone pictures. One, you need your Aadhaar card or the passport, which will also act as an identification proof. Second, you need to provide an address proof, and that cannot be your rental agreement. For that, you have to provide an electric bill, a gas bill, etc., etc., and also you can also provide a bank statement. And third, and you need to provide a certificate of your highest educational qualification. So these are the three documents you require. So you need to take the picture of your drone from top, along with a ruler or a scale on the side, so that you can get the sense of dimension of the drone, and one from the front, again with the scale or the ruler, to get the size and a dimension of the drone. So next, you need to provide a photograph of the serial number of the drone. For that, remove the battery, and the serial number can be found inside. So that is how you take a picture of the serial number of the drone. So once you have all the photographs and the documents, scan them and resize all the documents to 300 MB per photograph. So make sure you use photograph or whatever image editing software you use, and reduce the size of your documents and keep them ready, so that you don't have to do this while you are uploading this. So make sure you have all the documents, all the pictures, only 300 KB maximum limit. To register the drone, just go to Google and type Digital Sky and click on this first link, digitalsky.dgca.gov.in, and click on to go to drone enlistment site. So when you click on that site, you can see this page, It'll show you the current time that is remaining to register your drone, and it'll also have all the rules and regulations and the guidelines, and you can quickly go through them. It's very simple, just read them through and you'll understand everything, and go right to the bottom of the page and you can see analyst by drone. Click on that and it will ask you to fill in the details to obtain your OAN, the ownership acknowledgement number. Once you register, you'll receive a verification link. So you go to your mail, click on the link and your account is verified. Once your account is verified, you have to click on register as an individual and input all the details. Just fill in the whole form and then upload the file, upload the address proof, the identity proof. It is very easy. And then once you hit the submit button, you will receive the OAN number on your mail. Then the next step is to go to the profiles and enlist your drones. Whatever drones you have, if you have multiple drones, enlist them one by one into this section. Serial number for the ground control module and the serial number for the remote control module, which is nothing but the serial number of the drone. So if you have the serial number of the drone, you can put them in both the ground module and the remote control module, because I found out that both my remote control module and my ground control module is the same as the serial number of the drone. So if you own a drone which is not a DJI and you don't know how to find out the remote control module and the ground control module, just search on Google and you'll find a bunch of websites and forums telling you how to find out the ground control module and the remote control module. It is a very simple way of registering your drone. Once you upload all the pictures of the top angle, the front angle and the manufacturer serial number details, and then you hit the submit button and your drone gets registered within some time, and you get a mail on your inbox and it will show you that you have successfully registered your drone and have received the DAN number and the OAN number of your drone. Provided the security issues going on these days, I think this is a very, very good way of the Indian government to keep a track on how many drones are being operated in India and how many drones are being flown by individuals and how many drones are not legal in India. So I think the next time we fly with the drones or we travel with the drones, they will definitely ask for the DAN and the OAN number, and then if you can't provide them the numbers, the drone will be confiscated and it will be seized. So I hope this video is helpful for you, and if it is, please do not forget to hit the like and subscribe button, and if you know somebody who owns a drone, please tell him that you need to register the drone within 31st of Jan, and it's a very simple process, and ask them to subscribe to my channel also. So I keep on making such camera and videography and cinematographic related videos and tutorials. So do consider subscribing me and share it with your friends, and take care guys. That is all I have to say. See ya.